My name is Mike Cavnar. I'm a surgical oncologist at the University of Kentucky. I got interested in medicine back in high school, where I had an AP biology teacher that was very engaging, and she had sort of gotten me interested in the idea of going into medicine. Pretty quickly, I realized that surgery was what I wanted to do as opposed to some of the other medical fields. And through a long pathway, I've come down to become a surgical oncologist. Surgical oncology is an interesting mix of the hardest and most complex surgeries that we do within general surgery, but also marry that with the biology of cancer, which is incredibly complicated in a very fast-moving field. Here at UK, I do GI surgical oncology. So I do a lot of basically liver diseases, liver tumors, several different types, diseases of the biliary tree, pancreas, stomach, and small intestine. And for many of these diseases, we give chemotherapy first. And the idea is that a lot of the time, a big operation, a patient may not be well enough for a long time afterwards to get the chemotherapy they need. These are sick patients that have complicated problems and often complicated solutions to those problems. Getting the patient going into the right, down the right pathway towards feeling better, or at least knowing what's wrong so that they can plan for whatever time they have left, or hopefully get them to a curative pathway. And I find that really satisfying. I see the frustration and suffering in these patients' eyes and in their families' eyes, and the anxiety. And my own father was diagnosed with multiple myeloma while I was in medical school. As a second year medical student, we hadn't actually done the block on multiple myeloma yet. I told my instructor what the disease was, and I could see right away from his face that it was a terrible disease. Fortunately, along the time of his treatment, actually there were major advances made within multiple myeloma, and he had several bone marrow transplants and some chemo, and he's been cured. When it comes to a specific patient, I'll go over every single detail of every test that they've had, every image that's been taken, and make sure I'm not missing something. I see probably about 5 patients for every one that I operate on. And so that means for whatever reason, those other 4 patients either don't need an operation, or are not in good enough physical condition to undergo an operation, or are too advanced for an operation. But that doesn't mean I just kick them out the door. Those patients have a lot of other treatment options. Surgery is just one of the many different tools we have to deal with cancer. And that involves knowing what those treatments are, and whether it's chemotherapy, immunotherapy, radiation therapy, other surgeons, many different types of treatments, or palliative care. And there's a lot that goes into palliative care and helping patients feel better even if you can't cure them. The things that make the Marquee Cancer Center a really special place here is that this is a really top-notch institution, academic institution, that offers cutting-edge care in many different fields of cancer care that really rivals any of the major institutions across the country. And the beauty of it is it's right here in the middle of Kentucky.